Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this session, we want to use the Google Maps service in the app and show different locations on the map. In the previous session, we learned how to send a notification remotely using Firebase. Now we want to be directed to the map of that city by clicking on any of the items in the list. To do this, we create a new screen called Map. And we create a simple view inside it. Now I use this text in the home screen as a title on the map page. I import the font file and change the text. I also added set style. Now I need to define the map screen in a stack navigator, so that we can be directed to this page by clicking on each item. Here on the home screen, I define the map screen. And I import it. Now on the home page, we define navigation as props. We use items to navigate to the map page. Well, by clicking on this item, we will go to the map page. Well, here we have an error. The text component is not imported on the map page, so we do this. And as you can see, the error was fixed. Well, now we want to display the name of the clicked city instead of this text. So here we move the city name as a parameter to the map page. Now we define the route as props in the map page to use it to get the path parameter. Set the city parameter as text. And as you can see by clicking on each item, the name of that city will be transferred to the map page. Well, now we want to show a map under the city name that specifies the location of that city. To use Google Maps in a React Native project, we can use the React Native Maps module. To view the installation instructions, go to this link. Here we can install the module using this command. If you are working on iOS, use this section. And if you are working on Android, make this setting. First, copy this part to the build.gradle file. One of the build files is in the Android folder. And the other is in the app folder. We copy them into this file in the dependencies section. Now we need to put the Google Maps API key in the Android manifest file. You can get this key from your Google Developer account. First, we go to Google Maps platform, where there is a document related to the use of Google Maps. Then you can use this link to go to Google Cloud platform. There you can create your own project or choose from previous projects. Then copy the API key you already created or create a new API key from here. Be sure to enable the Maps SDK for Android from the library section. So in this field, you have to enter your API key. The key I put in the project will be removed and will not work for you. Well, then we put this part in this path and in the application tag. Well, now we have to use the MapView component below this text. First, we import the MapView component in this way. Then, in this way, we use it on the page. We define a style for it to cover the whole screen. These two parameters determine the extent of the map, which we leave here unchanged. And these two parameters determine the longitude and latitude that we must have for each city. These coordinates can be transferred to the map page when each city is clicked. That's why I changed the API response and added the latitude and longitude of each city. So I changed the API address in the Redux folder and the actions file to update the response. Now we send the latitude and longitude of each item to the map page. And we use them in the map screen. We leave these two parameters unchanged. Now in the terminal, go to the Android folder and sync the Gradle. Now let's go back to the project folder and run the app. Now by clicking on each item, we will see a map related to the coordinates of the same city. Also, by holding down the control key and dragging, we can have the pinch action in the emulator for zoom in and zoom out. So there we go, we learned how to use the Google Maps service in the app. So in the next video, we will learn how to use the device camera in the app. Now, if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you in the next session.